Hello and welcome to another weekly update. Welcome to what is the last weekly update of the year of 2018. And there's no real big announcements or anything to make like that. You know, since last week it's been, you know, holiday season everywhere and a real kind of wind down towards the end of the year. But I thought it was interesting anyway to kind of look back at 12 months and see what I recorded for this weekly update on the last week of the year in 2017. And it's kind of interesting because the big announcement, if you go back, I'll put a link in the notes so you can go and watch it again if you want, but the big announcement really from that week was Microsoft announcing a whole bunch of new features for Teams. And there was a really kind of frenetic pace of development at that time going into the beginning of 2018 and leading up to around kind of Easter 2018 time. And it was interesting to kind of see, you know, where Microsoft Teams was a year ago to where it is today. And I think a year ago it was huge amounts of potential, huge amounts of promise and excitement, but it wasn't right for lots of workloads. You know, it was missing key features that people needed in order to make it their tool for collaboration and for meetings and calling and all these other workloads. And I think what we've seen, you know, 12 months on, a lot of those concerns have been addressed, and it's a very different product to the one it was 12 months ago. And so going into this kind of end of year, we don't see that same frenetic pace of development. There's still definitely features that are coming and that are being worked on, and I want to talk about those in a second. But Teams is a much more stable product. I don't mean stable as in it works or it doesn't work, I just mean like in terms of its maturity. And we've seen that through in the development platform as well. You know, some big announcements this year around the calling API and more API functionality that takes on some of that traditional, that workload that traditionally something like UCMA might have done. So back-end services, bots, users being able to talk to services, being able to call into IVRs, to do call routing, to kind of drop contacts into meetings and control meeting spaces. All these types of functionality and all these features are now kind of things you can do today. So that's really exciting. And again, it comes down to that maturity of the product. So there are still things being worked on at the moment. And that's the second thing I'd like to talk about. So I just thought I'd have a look at the Microsoft 365 roadmap for this, on this last week of the year, to see what we can expect to show up going into next year. And I'll put a link for the specific URL that takes you to just Microsoft Teams features that are in development or are rolling out. I'm not going to go through all of them, but it's interesting to see there's some features that are kind of more advanced calling features. So things like shared line appearance and call park, group call pickup. And then there's some kind of workflowy type things. So being able to take private chat and add tabs, that would be interesting. Being able to do screen sharing in private chat. And so again, it's not, you know, a million and one features like it was last year. It's much more about building on the kind of base platform now. It's about making it better, making it right for more and more workloads, fixing those gaps, you know, where there are things that aren't right for groups of people, but it's much smaller groups of people now than it was 12 months ago. So I think that all just speaks to kind of maturity of the product. There's a couple of other things looking slightly further out as well. Things like Teams templates are still showing as Q2 19. So we'll kind of wait for that stuff to come. It's good to go through and just see what we can expect to come into next year. So I'd urge you to go and have a look at that page. It's a good way of seeing, you know, what's coming down the line. And shameless plug as well, there's a blog post somewhere. I won't put a link to it, but you can find it if you look around. That I did about getting a specific RSS feed for each of these kind of filters. Anyway, final thing I want to leave you with at the end of the year is something I left you with at the end of last year, but I thought it was really good, so I thought I'm going to do it again. And that's a blog post about how you can conduct a end of year productivity review. So I'll link to the blog post, but it's kind of three things really. It's a list of things you've accomplished this year, a kind of look to understand where you're investing your time and your energies, and then based on both of those things, the three, the kind of big three things you want to achieve next year. It's not just work, it's personal work, it's work life, it's, you know, hobbies, it's whatever it is. It's the stuff that makes up the time whilst you're awake. So it's important to firstly categorize and metricize those things, because otherwise you don't really know kind of what your baseline is. It's good to look back and understand where you spend your time in 2018. And then if you're cool with that and if you're happy with that balance, then great, you know, reaffirm it for 2019. If you're not, this is a good time to kind of look at how you can make some changes to achieve more of the kind of work-life balance, or whatever it is, the balance of the, you know, the things that you think are most important in the year ahead. So with that, have a wonderful new year, and I will speak to you again for the first weekly update of 2019. Goodbye.